The Miss America pageant helps support young women by awarding scholarships to the future leaders of tomorrow. And here this morning to talk about her latest triumph is the new Miss Rhode Island, Ivy DePew. Good morning.
Good morning.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
This was my first time actually judging a contest like this. Mm-hmm. And I didn't realize how intense the process was to get to winning Miss Rhode Island. It's not as easy as everyone thinks.
Oh, no. Miss America is the largest scholarship provider for women in the world, as you may know. And so we prepare year-round for everything from the onstage swimsuit, competition and evening gown, and, of course, talent. But we year-round promote our platforms. Mine is promoting military families and supporting service members and veterans. So it's a year-round process.
And before you actually make it to the actual competition itself, you have to go before the judges. There is a day-long process. What's it like to be standing outside the door, knowing that you've got to go in before all of these judges and get questions fired at you, rapid fire?
Well, you, of course, are very familiar because you were one of my judges at the pageant. It is a 10-minute private interview, and you are just trying to center yourself, remember who you are, remember what kinds of things that you want to leave the room with the judges knowing. So, of course, I wanted to let you know that I was ready for the job of Miss Rhode Island and ready to promote my platform of supporting military families at the national level.
This is not, a lot of people will hear pageants, they think it's an easy job, you just go out, but it is intense. There are a lot of appearances that you're making. You're actually going to the post socks. You're going to throw out the first pitch.
Yes.
Are you? Let's just put it this way. Are you more nervous for throwing out the first pitch than you were for the competition? And how is your arm?
Well, I'm actually meeting someone this afternoon to teach me how to throw a ball, and so I've learned to throw harder and throw higher than you expect, and it may or may not make it to the catcher.
Because there may be more pressure in that and making sure that it actually gets to the catcher than the Miss Rhode Island competition itself.
Certainly.
All right. What's the platform that you are going to try to promote all year long?
It's titled United We Stand, and it is all about supporting U.S. military service members, veterans, and their families. I was raised in a civilian family, so with my background, I knew very little about what our service members needed, what our veterans needed when they returned home, and of course, what support that families need, especially the children. And so I've been working with the Rhode Island National Guard, with an ROTC program here in the Ocean State to learn about what their needs are and how we as civilians and other military people can support them.
Well, that's great because they do such great work, and that's why we have the freedom in this country that we do because of them. All right, let's talk about the night of competition. You are there. You have there is a talent portion, and then there's a swimsuit, there's evening gown. There are questions again being fired at you rapid fire, and then the moment of truth comes where you are standing on that stage with a bunch of other women, and you're waiting to hear if you are going to be Miss Rhode Island. Were you freaked out? Were you nervous? Because everybody holds hands. We all see this. All the girls hold hands, and they're all, hoping the best for each other. But the moment of truth comes, and you really want to win, and there you are. There you are getting the big announcement. What did that feel like?
There is that moment. I was very nervous, but again, I was at peace. I competed for the outstanding teen title for 2 years before competing here. It was my second time competing for the title of Miss Rhode Island. So I was nervous, but I was at peace knowing that this was my last year, my last shot. I just received my master's degree, so I figured if I went home with the crown, I'd be happy. And if not, then my life would still be just as great and just as fulfilling.
Well, not only do you go home with the crown, which is pretty cool, but you also go home with a scholarship money, which I'm sure your family is even happier about.
Oh, yes, certainly. I have my master's degree at Brown, and of course, I was able to pay off all of my undergraduate tuition from the University of Memphis using Miss America scholarship dollars. So I walked away with over $6,000 in scholarships alone from the pageant, in addition to a year of excitement ahead of me.
Which says a lot about the competition itself. It actually gives you money and goes to paying for school. While you have already done very well for yourself as far as school, this money always goes a long way and will help out.
Yes, certainly.
What was the family's reaction? Because I did see them there, and they were so excited.
Everyone keeps telling me that my mother is fired from her job. She was actually putting the camera in the bag, thinking, oh, it's Ivy. We've done this several times. She's not going to walk away winning. And so we have no pictures of the top five.
Nice.
My mom was trying to figure out the quickest route to the dressing room. And then once I won, she quickly pulled the camera back out and was able to get some of my crowning moment and walking across the stage waving.
Well, that's great. Well, congratulations to you. It's going to be an exciting year. The year will go by pretty quick. So enjoy every second of
it. Yes, sir. Thank you.
And we're glad to have you here with us and come back again. If you would like to learn more about Miss Rhode Island or the Miss America pageant, just head to our website. By the way, I think she just called me sir. It's the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com.